Facebook is rebranding its parent company and will now go by the name Meta, as Mark Zuckerberg tries to distance the social media behemoth from mounting scandals after leaked whistleblower documents claimed its platforms harmed users and stoked anger. Zuckerberg made the announcement Thursday at the Facebook Connect Augmented and Virtual Reality Conference. During heat announcement, workers outside the company's Silicon Valley headquarters pulled down a curtain bearing the company's iconic-like sign to reveal the new name and logo. Meta refers to the metaverse, Zuckerberg's vision for the company's transition into shared augmented reality, where users work and play in virtual world environments. The attempt to escape reality couldn't come at a better time for the embattled brand, which will retain the Facebook name, but Facebook Incorporated, the parent company that also owns Instagram and WhatsApp, will now go under the new title Meta. It will begin trading under MVRS on December 1st. The company is steeped deep in crisis after whistleblower Frances Haugen leaked internal documents and made bombshell claims that it puts profits over people by knowingly harming teenagers with its content. Haugen, a Facebook former product manager, left the company with tens of thousands of confidential documents that she copied in secret and released to roughly 24 news outlets. On Thursday, it was revealed how Facebook researchers are said to have had extensive knowledge that coronavirus and misinformation about the COVID-19 vaccine existed on the company's apps, yet did little to combat it, let alone share the information with the White House. Documents presented by Facebook whistleblower Frances Haugen show how multiple studies were run producing a various number detailing the types of users who were most likely to share fake news, lawmakers, academics, and the White House urged Facebook to share such information publicly. Facebook employees also knew misinformation about the coronavirus was dominating parts of the social media platform, creating echo chamber-like effects, ultimately reinforcing hesitancy over the vaccine. Haugen testified before Congress on October 5th and British Parliament on Monday, presenting findings on the harm social media caused young users. One revealed that 13.5% of British teenagers and 6% of American teenagers experiencing suicidal thoughts said that they traced them to Instagram. A message posted on an internal message board in March 2020 and revealed in Haugen's documents said the app revealed that 32% of girls said Instagram made them feel worse about their bodies if they were already having insecurities. Another recent claim against the company is that Instagram bombards women and girls who suffer from eating disorders with images and videos of exceedingly thin females and others afflicted with anorexia. Internal documents revealed that Instagram's algorithm curates options based on searches and preferences of users who express interest in dieting, weight loss, and thinness. Instagram researchers this year conducted an experiment in which they typed in terms like #skinny and #thin are then offered to browse through other accounts that feature dangerously emaciated women and girls. Another core finding in the leaked documents was that Facebook staff have reported for years that they are concerned about the company's failure to police hate speech, and that its algorithms flooded users with extremist content and conspiracy theories based on their political beliefs. Internal messages from staff at the social media giant show that they blamed themselves for January 6th Capitol riot after giving extremist content a platform on the site. One of the darkest days in the history of democracy and self-governance. History will not judge us kindly, said one worker, while another said, "We've been fueling this fire for a long time, and we shouldn't be surprised it's now out of control." Haugen's leaked documents also reveal that Facebook potentially mislead the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission by failing to disclose that its popularity among young users is slumping. It is said to have failed to explain that many of its overall users are people with more than one account on its sites, meaning the actual number of users could be up to 11% fewer than its figures would suggest. One trend shows that the time spent on Facebook by U.S. teenagers was down 16% from 2020 to 2021, and that young adults, between 18 and 29, were spending 5% less time on the app, according to reporting from Bloomberg. Despite an avalanche of damaging whistleblower claims surfacing at the start of this week in what became known as the Facebook Papers, Meta on Monday reported soaring profits for the latest quarter. The company said that its net income grew 17% in the July-September period to $9.19 billion, buoyed by strong advertising revenue. That's up from profits of $7.85 billion a year earlier. The term metaverse can refer to digital spaces, which are made more lifelike by the use of virtual reality or augmented reality. Our mission remains the same. It's still about bringing people together, he said, adding, "Now we have a new North Star to help bring the metaverse to life." He added that the word means beyond in Greek and symbolizes that there is always more to build and always a next chapter in the story. "I believe the metaverse is the next chapter of the internet, and it's the next chapter of our company too," he said, adding, "While most tech companies focus on how people could connect to technology, we focus on building technology so people could connect with each other."